I finished business school and I was in this in-between stage. I ended up selling hair extensions out the trunk of my car. I think people were like, what the hell are you talking about? Growing up in Oakland, I noticed the relationship between women and their hairstylists. I knew that I wanted to build a company, and I saw the opportunity to empower hairstylists in my community with an internet company that sold hair extensions.
He wasn't thinking about hair before I told him to go look for it. The hair import industry was driven by Black businesswomen like myself, because we were the ones whose clients were generally buying hair, but we weren't the people that were making money off of it.
African Americans are buying over $6 billion of hair extensions every year. That's a massive amount of dollars leaving the community. That's really what we wanted to focus on and fix.
When he brought Mayvenn to me, there was just something electric about it. It was the potential of the good that this could do for the Black community.
When friends or your family put up money for your dream, for me, it makes it even more serious, because these are the people that I want to protect the most.
As Black women, we're taught that hair is our crown. It adorns us. Inspiration is invaluable when it comes to hair.
Hair and beauty are incredibly visual, and Pinterest is this world that allows people to discover and play and innovate and inspire each other visually. So our customers and stylists love it. Today, Mayvenn is a network of over 50,000 hairstylists across the country. We do over $30 million in revenue. People think that as the business gets bigger, you feel better. But actually, it's growing because you are right out there on the edge, pushing the boundary every single day. You have to really love that hustle. And I happen to love that hustle.
Curls, bro, you remember?